Hi, I'm Darcy Tolenko. I'm the new Extension Field Crop Pathologist for Purdue University. And today we're out looking at diseases in corn. We've had a lot of calls about Physoderma brown spot. And so I wanted to show you some of the symptoms that we're seeing here in our research plots. And so today we have a lot of the leaf symptoms appearing. We have yellow, brown, small little specks occurring. And then along the midrib, there's a diagnostic purple lesion that's occurring along the midrib. The one unique thing about Physoderma is the infection probably occurred about the V5 to V9 stage. So really, it's really too late to do anything right now because the pathogen's already within the corn. But you can actually see the characteristic banding that occurs along leaf tissue here, where it infected as that leaf tissue was growing out of the meristem tissue. And the spores, which are zoospores, actually a free-swimming spore, were swimming around in the water that was collecting within the whorl. And so that's why we see the diagnostic bands occurring. To identify Physoderma brown spot in the field, it may be confused with some of the other commonly known pathogens. Early on, the small bright yellow symptoms could be similar to spider mite aphid damage in corn, or maybe similar to our gray leaf spot early on, or even northern corn leaf blight, depending on the stage of our pathogen. So we really have to be cautious on what we're looking at. You can always send samples to the plant pest diagnostic lab here at Purdue, where we can give you a positive confirmation of what pathogen may be affecting your crop. This disease has a limited effect on yield. We really don't think of it as a major pathogen here in Indiana. We may see it occurring more in fields that have a continuous corn after corn, or where there's been a lot of residue left, or if they're switching to a no-till situation where the residue is remaining on the soil, we might start to see this increase in those areas. There may be some variability in our varieties, whether they're more susceptible or not to Physoderma. I do know that some more varieties have a more susceptibility in infection in the leaves, and then some may be more susceptible with the stalk rot. So you need to be considerate if you're just starting to see this disease appear in your fields, maybe looking at your variety selection for those that may have some resistance available.